VIP pre-registration at our GPs just got even better. We here at Channel Fireball and Cascade Games are proud to offer a different exclusive, limited edition pin to our VIPs at each of the 5 Grand Prix we are hosting this year. That's Sacramento, Phoenix, Salt Lake City, Portland, and Los Angeles. If you collect all 5, you can receive the limited edition Planeswalker VIP pin. Don't stress about your GP experience this year with us. Pre-register as a VIP, sleep in, and collect pins.
All right, we're here with another cube draft. I missed a little bit of time trying to get this Camtasia set up. The cards I'm really considering are Ancestral Visions, Mishra's Workshop, Ravages of War, and that's about it. I think I'm going with the Ravages of War just because that's the kind of guy I am. I really like to play that type of deck. But Mishra's Workshop is interesting as a first choice. Smokestack in the same pack kind of sucks because you would really want that to be in the same deck. I'm just going to take Ravages of War. I really like it. We'll see where that goes. We have a Metalworker. That would have been pretty good with the Workshop. There's a Tinker, too. What do I want to take here? There's Ancient Tomb, which is reasonable in basically every deck ever. Hero Blade holds pretty strong if I want to be like White Weenie, as is a Johnny. Chromox is relatively strong in a lot of different decks. Or I could ignore the fact that I passed the Workshop and take Metalworker here and just see what happens. I don't think it's the craziest idea. I could also just take Tinker. Tinker's really strong. I think I'm going with Ancient Tomb. It's just the best colorless thing ever. I'm going to go with Sword of War and Peace here. Thalia would be a close second. If it wheels, I'll definitely take it. Show and Tell plus Tinker. Somebody's going to have a pretty sweet deck there. Our deck's not going to be sweet, but it's just going to beat down, and I'll be fine with that. No Rod might hurt us, might hurt other decks more, so I'm not too worried about that. Couple duels here, a couple white cards. We'll see if anything wheels. But I'm fine being aggressive white. I think aggressive white is a completely reasonable archetype. Like Leonin Relic Warder here is pretty strong. It's just disrupting your opponent. So I'm taking that over Archangel and over Chain Lightning. Chain Lightning is much closer than Archangel. I don't think Archangel is that strong. You really want 1-2s and 3s for the most part, and then you really want some backbreakers like Ravages of War and Sword of War and Peace. So we'll see. Alright, what do we have here? Nothing for White Weenie. But we do have some strong cards potentially to play with Ravages of War. Coalition Relic is one of my favorite cards in cubes. I think I'm gonna end up taking that here. Mindstone and Izzet Signet were both reasonable too. Maybe we'll have more of a prison deck. I don't know. We'll see. I'm gonna take Coalition Relic here though. Maybe we wheel that workshop and we're happy. I don't It's potential. I think I'm going to take Catastrophe here because that's a second Ravages of War to have in the same deck, and there's really nothing here to take in terms of hating outside of maybe Gaia's Cradle. Be a bit of a stretch at this point, but I could see it. Elspeth's pretty decent. I think I'm going to take her. In terms of just cards that work with these two cards, Weather Wayfarer is also an option, but I think Elspeth is slightly more powerful. Also a decent Coalition Relic. We'll see if a workshop wield. I don't think it will, but maybe people undervalue it in terms of its power level because it doesn't necessarily do anything for you. You have to really be a specific archetype. So if that wield and Metalworker wheels, maybe our deck ends up very different, maybe very prisony. I mean, that could happen even if those things don't wheel. But all right, we get Path to Exile here. A little counterproductive to blowing up people's lands unless you do it in the reverse order, which yes, it's pretty strong. It's also just one of the better cards in cube. There's just so many powerful show and tell tinker effects that you really need to have some protection against that sort of thing. All right, it did not wheel, although Smokestack did. But Flicker Wisp did, and Flicker Wisp is a pretty strong card, I think, for a lot of different reasons. It just gives you a pretty versatile card. It works in this deck with things like Elspeth to reset it. You could blink a land potentially and then kill all lands. You can, I don't know, does some different things. We'll see if it ends up doing anything in our deck. Kami of Ancient Law is not necessarily a high pick, so I'm not too worried about passing that. All right, Ajani came back around. I could see taking Thraktos because it's a stronger card, but being mono-white at this point is pretty good. And this is another Planeswalker to work with both of our Wrath effects. So right now we're really built around these two cards, I would say. We're not so aggressive or anything of that nature, but we'll see. Alright, we got Thalia back, which I think, maybe not. Maybe it is Wrath of God. We're probably going to end up being a lot more controlling the more I look at our deck. And having access to Wrath is just going to be able to beat a lot of the fair strategies. Catastrophe is a Wrath as well, so that's good. And then this is basically a Wrath. Alright, just going to take Masticore here. Nothing really special. I don't really want the Izzet Boy that works. I will take a Bounce Hand here, though. I would say green is more likely than black. No, I'll take a black. Black has better prison effects like Nether Void in the cube, so there's a chance that I want to play it in this deck. Oh, Goof grabbed the last pick there. Took a Torch Fiend over, I don't know what. Probably nothing good. Hopefully nothing good. We'll see. We open up for pack two. Right now, we're mono white. Pretty interesting looking deck. I think that means we have to take Swords to Plowshares here and not really argue about it. We probably will wheel Route, so that'll be nice. It's not really a highly sought after card. And this pack's pretty good, but I'm fine with Swords to Plowshares. Alright, what white goodness do we have here? We have this card. That's interesting. I don't know how good it is. There's Sorin here, which is definitely a solid Planeswalker. Might just be the pickup over this. I don't think this is too impressive. And we already have the Orzhov Basilica, which is kind of neat. So I think I'm just going to take this guy. Pack's overall pretty weak, I would say. A lot of mid-range cards. But that's another Planeswalker, so never be... Ooh. I got to take Skullclamp here, I think. But I want Simulacrum and Bitter Blossom just as much. But this is already really good with just this and this. Maybe I don't need to have it. Maybe I should just take Bitter Blossom. Bitter Blossom feels like the card I want to take here, but if I have Bitter Blossom and pass this, I'm going to feel so dumb. I'm just going to take the Skull Clamp and hope to make use of it, better use of it. I think it's okay in our deck right now. I would love that Bitter Blossom wheel. That would be like an early Christmas present. But I won't cross my fingers. Do I take Spear or Tide Hollow Scholar here? I think I want the Tide Hollow Scholar. This guy is another reason to be black-white. Really strong hand disruption. I think Spear is pretty reasonable, but we're more of a prisony deck, in which case I think that guy's services are slightly better. Ooh, Balance. That is a big game. Lightning Helix would be reasonable too. Acid Plateau and Silverblade, but Balance is too good. Alright, what do we have here? We have another Void. That's one of those cards I was talking about. I don't think we want that, though. I think we want Wall of Omens here. It's just a decent defensive cantrip. I could see taking Selesnya Signet, too. Maybe actually Selesnya Signet might just be the pick. I don't think so, though. I think I want something to protect a little bit of my Planeswalkers, make Flicker Wisp a little bit better. Yeah, I think we're going with that. I could see Selesnya Signet putting up a reasonable argument there. We still have a little bit of time to pick up a couple more artifacts that work well with this. Basically mana accelerants. But the Planeswalker plan is pretty strong right now. And we have like a little decent equipment plan. So I'm not too worried about it. We have Oblivion Ring here. That's a pretty good one. No reason to take Figure of Destiny, that's for sure. The Abyss is another one of those strong cards, but if we have pretty equally strong cards, and I think they're fairly equal, at least in terms of these strategies. Actually, this might be better. I don't have any art. I have just the Tide Hollow Scholar, so I'd have to just keep making dudes every turn. Yeah, I'm just going to go with the Oblivion Ring. The Abyss is definitely one of those cards that I would have liked to pick up, but I don't think letting Oblivion Ring go for it is worth it. Just having an answer to non-creatures when I already have Balance, Wrath of God, Catastrophe, multiple Plow effects. Like, I just want... Ooh. Maybe I do get both. This is kind of an interesting card in this deck. I think I'm just going to take it. I don't know if I'm going to play with it, but it's very interesting. Works well with Skull Clamp. Artifact, creature, or land. Alright, Route did wheel. No black cards here that we're interested in. Chandra would be pretty decent, but I'm happy with just having a Route for the sideboard. I don't think we need to play it main, but... ooh, this wheeled. And this deals with anything, so... We'll definitely take it here. I could see taking a Mirror Angel. That's another token producer. But I have so many planeswalkers, I don't think I necessarily. Maybe I do want this. I have the skull clamp. Alright, I'm taking a mirror angel. I don't know how good that unexpected, or whatever it is, expected result, whatever the heck that card, that unexpected journey. It seems decent. It's like an Oblivion Ring, but you have to put like at least 5 mana into it for it to really be valuable, I would say. I'll take this for the sideboard. Ooh, this wield. That's pretty sweet. I think I'm taking it. I think I'm playing it. I don't know if I'm playing it. Definitely taking it. So, am I going to play this guy ever? Thinking about just taking this. I'll just stick with this. We have enough black incentive at this point. Just Sword and Tidehall Skull are both pretty big. And then we have Basilica. Sure. So our deck's pretty interesting. It's like a mid-rangey prison deck. I thought we had a Thalia. Did we not pick up a Thalia? What would I have taken over Thalia? Apparently I did not pick a Thalia.